Hey, how's it going? It's Ben from Accurate, and here we're here with another segment of the quarantine series. And today what we wanted to talk to, we have a lot of people asking us about arm lengths. And as you can see in front of Dave, we've got all the different arm lengths that we offer for the reels. And basically you're dealing with like a 3-inch arm length that you see on the 300, the 400, the 500 size reels. Then you're dealing with a 3.5 for a 600, 600 narrow. Then we have a 3.8 that was designed for jigging, and then we have a 4.4 1/4, it's 4.25, that basically was developed for slow pitch jigging. But today's thing is basically to answer the questions. I got two of the guys that designed the reels to answer all your questions on why people are using what arms for what. Like fishing, I've figured it out, but when I come back to these guys, I know a lot of times I don't understand why I'm using them. So, you know, a lot of things with this, with basic, the basic arm length is the shorter the arm, a lot of times you're going to get the speed that you want on the crank. So remember, the length of the arm, the diameter of the spool is dependent on, plus the gear ratio is all dependent on how much line retrieval you get. But you also have to think about gear ratio. And with the gear ratio, if you go with slower gear ratios or higher gear ratios, everything changes. So
yeah, there's a relationship between the gear ratio, the spool diameter, and the arm length, right? Those three things are going on.
Right.
Yep. So you really got to think about what you're trying to achieve there. I know a lot of the fishermen out there have different needs depending on what type of fishing they're doing.
Right.
And so, you know, with the longer arm, you get the longer leverage. You get more leverage against, so you get more power, right, of turning that handle arm if it's longer. But also you're traveling a lot more, so there's a little bit of work involved in getting that leverage. And then how does that relate to the speed of the jig or whatever your lure is?
Right.
And then what your line ticket is.
Yeah. Right? So a lot, like, I'm going to go right real quickly with the slow pitch jigging that everybody's doing. A lot of the slow pitch jigging that everybody's doing, they're using the longest arm you see here with an 800 narrow reel, which is this one, or this one, which is a 600 narrow reel. So what really to me shows how, like, these guys are studs, because they're using 6-to-1 gear ratios. All right. Yeah. So the 6-to-1 gear ratio on the longest arm you have, when you start trying to pull on something with a high gear ratio, it's super hard to turn around because of the amount of teeth these guys put in the actual gears themselves. So when the guys are slow pitch jigging, they've got a rhythmic deal that they're doing. A lot of times those guys, just so you understand it, the rod compensates for a lot of the pressure that the fish puts on you. So if you're fishing for the denizens of the deep, the big groupers, sometimes doggies, whatever you're fishing for, if you got the right rod that bends, it takes the pressure off you, but it's also gonna help you be able to turn the handle when you want, because the rod's gonna compensate by the action of the rod every time you turn the handle.
It's a rhythm thing, right?
The rhythm.
So you gotta get, you know, there are some guys that they get a one arm length and they don't like it, and then they want a different one. So that's why we offer different sizes, because maybe their cadence is a little different than someone else, right?
Yeah.
And you know, like this one too, Ben, you know, you look at how big this spool is, and with a 6-to-1 gear ratio, this thing rips.
Yeah.
I mean, you turn the handle, you're pulling a lot of inches per crank.
Yep.
Because the diameter of the spool, think about every revolution of that spool going around, and it's a 6-to-1 gear ratio, 6 times around for every crank.
And all those line retrieval rates are inside on our website webpage. You can see what the line take-in is on each one of these reels. So you can kind of get closer in your estimation of what the line take-in and what leverage you want on what.
Yeah, because what you're looking at, these, you're looking at like a single speed like this is a 4-to-1 to 6-to-1. That's what these are offered to be, 4-to-1, 6-to-1s. But you go over here, this is 4-7-to-1 and 6-to-1. Mm-hmm. So it's a little bit different. Each one of them has a little bit different way to look at things. Again, 4-to-1 to 6-to-1. But I want to really throw a curveball at you. If the arbor is this big and your spool's this big and you're halfway in between having a full spool of line, the line retrieval is not going to be the same as it is with the full spool. So if you almost get spooled by a fish and you're trying to go through and get line back on that, there's going to be a lot of cranks just to get the line that you're putting on there. The larger diameter of the spool is going to have more line retrieval.
Right.
So with us, again, any of the reels that we offer, you got a 300, you got the 400, the 500 narrow. The narrow reels are all the ones that are for jigging. When you look at our jigging size, it's the silver one here. It's the 3.8. A lot of guys get that for jigging, and a lot of guys are jigging with single speeds. But I think more so now with a lot of these guys fishing tunas, the guys that are jigging with the single speeds now are going to the two speeds, and they're using the longer handle. So just remember, we offer any of the stuff that you see here with, you know, whatever handle you want to put on there, but make sure you understand why you're putting the handle on there, because sometimes when you want a lot of torque, make sure that you can handle the torque that you ask for.
Yeah. Yep.
Would that be about the fair thing to say? What else have we missed here for these guys?
Well, you know, now you're talking about, you know, the retrieving with the halfway on the spool, right?
Yeah.
You know, the other thing, just thinking about the same principle, is that you also have a lot more pressure on the fish in terms of drag.
Right.
Right? Just, I mean, we're talking about gear ratios and leverage and line taking when you're turning the handle, but it's the opposite
when it comes to drag.
With drag,
yeah.
Right? Drag halfway down the spool, your drag pressure's gone up a lot.
It's twice, right?
Yeah.
Half a spool, your drag pressure goes up twice. But here's another thing to throw at you. We make reels. Reels go through and gather line. The rods are the things a lot of times that will take the pressure off of you. We also have slow pitch rods that go with any of the reels that we have too. So remember, the actions of the rods are things that are gonna help you be more comfortable in your fishing experience. So remember that it's not just the reel, but it's the combination of everything. And the other thing is, if you have piece, depending on how big a piece of like floral or whatever else, floral doesn't stretch that much. And if it's a small piece, it won't matter. But remember, sometimes when you get bit in 2,000 feet, all you're going to do is whine, because you're not going to lift up and set the hook. You got to whine, and you got to watch the rod bend. The rod has to load, then you can make some sort of movement on the fish.
You know, and if you guys got any questions about any of the stuff Ben's going over on the technical side of what rod, what reel, and what arm you want, just call us. We're available. We're here, you know, every day, Monday through Friday. We're totally available to answer any of your questions. Just call us up, and we'll give you our recommendation, what we think would be the best for what you're doing.
Yep, and any questions can always go to info@accuratefishing.com, and you can get any of us here to help you with that stuff. But we appreciate everything that's going on. Again, we're trying to get your mind off of fishing. I know this is like our disclaimer. Everybody has their own way of doing things, and there's not just one way. So if you have a different way, let us know. That's great. But all we're doing is we're telling you how we went through. They designed the reels. We use the reels. This is what we do with them. If there's anything else we can do, let us know. We'll do it.
Yep.
So from us,
keep fishing. Fish hard. Fish accurate.
Fish accurate. We'll see you.
Thanks.